So in this video, we just shall look at how we are just going to calculate our Hamiltonian circuit with the help of our backtracking approach. Okay. So initially, we just shall look at what is a backtracking approach. So backtracking approach is nothing but it is a kind of an approach which just identifies a component. Okay. And then it just evaluates the component and then just moves in the same path of the component. So if it finds a newer component, it just moves on in the particular way. And if it doesn't find any solution, or if the path is being left off or it has found the dead end, what it does is that it just travels back and then it just starts with the previous component which it has found out the answer for, right? So this is how your backtracking approach works, right? So today's problem, we are just going to look at Hamiltonian circuit, right? So Hamiltonian circuit is nothing but you will be given with a particular graph and then you have to identify the Hamiltonian circuit out of it. So what does the Hamiltonian circuit means is that you just have to start with a given node. Okay, so any one of the node randomly taken inside the graph, you just have to start with, and then you have to travel each and every node exactly once. And then you just have to come back to the starting node. So this is how we just call it as a Hamiltonian circuit, right? So since we are just following a backtracking approach for identifying the Hamiltonian circuit, what we have to do is that we just have to construct a state space tree diagram for it, and then we just have to look at it. Okay. So right now what we shall do, we just shall look at it with the help of an example. So we just shall consider this simple graph for constructing our Hamiltonian circuit, right? So what we have to do, we just have to construct a state space tree diagram for it. Okay. So initially what we have to do is that we just have to mention the initial state. So you just have to identify any one of the place where you are going to start. So initially what we do is that we just consider the first letter of the alphabet as our primary source. So since we are just having it as an alphabetical order, so I'm just taking A over here. So this is the initial node, or this is the root node of my state space tree. So I'm just going to start my traveling from A and I have to end up with A. So this is where I just start my circuit traveling. Okay. So what am I going to do next is that I just have to mark the branches such a way that the possible ways for me to travel from A. So here there are two possible ways, which means that there are two outgoing nodes from my A. So C and B. So what I do is I just mark it as a child. Okay, so I'm just marking B as its child and also C as its child, right? So these are the two possible ways which B could travel from A. So right now I'm just standing at A. So what are the possible ways for me to travel? B and C. So I'm just marking B and C right over here, right? So the next term, what I have to do is I just have to take the next node, which I'm just taking it as B. So what are the opportunities? So the opportunities are A, C and D for me to travel, right? So here what I have to do, I just have to travel, or I just have to mark it. So A I'm just marking, right? So the next place for me to travel is C, I'm just marking it, and then the next place I could travel to D, so I'm just marking it. So these are the three possible ways I could travel, so I'm just marking it out. See, once after marking it out, you cannot visit your nodes more than once. So here A is already visited. The A should be the last node which you are visiting. So this particular path I'm just ignoring. Why? Because is that we haven't visited our C and D yet. So I cannot travel in this particular path further. So here what I do is I just travel further. So travel further means I just take my C. So what are the possibilities for me to travel in this particular path? So I just have A, B and D, right? So I could travel in A, right, B and D. So here what I am considering is, so B I have already traveled, I could not travel in this particular path again. So D, A I am having it as it, so I cannot travel it from this particular path. So I am just considering D over here. So here for D, what are the possibilities for me to travel? C and B are the possibilities for me to travel. So I am just considering B and I am also considering C, right? So here B is already visited, so I cannot travel in this particular path. So I'm just leaving it as it. So I'm just considering C alone, right? So similarly, what I have to do is I just have to travel from D right now. So from D, what are the possible paths for me to travel? C and B are the possible paths for me to travel, right? So what I do, I just take my C, right, and my B. Okay, so here what has happened, C I have already visited, so I cannot travel to C again. So B I have already visited, I cannot travel to B again. So the entire path has become dead end. Okay, so right now we just shall consider our C over here. So what are the possibilities for me to travel from C? So A, B and D are the possibilities. So I am just marking it out, A, B and D. right? So here whether I have to check whether all the nodes are being visited. So here I'm just taking it out. So A, B, C and D. So here this particular path is being visited. So which means that all the nodes are visited and I'm just getting back to A. So which means I have traveled from A, I have traveled to B, and then I have traveled to D, I have traveled to C, and I have got back to A. So this is one of our optimal solution, right? So as I said earlier, we cannot stop it once after identifying one of the solution. We have to go for all the possible solutions, right? So here we are just standing at B right now. So whether there is a possible path for me to do it, so B is already visited, I cannot consider it. So D is already visited, I cannot consider it, right? So this is for this left subtree I just have to traverse. So we just have to similarly do it for the right subtree, right? So we are just standing at C right now. So what are the possibilities for us to travel from C? So possibilities are A, B and D. So I'm just marking it out. So A, B and D, I'm just marking it out, right? So here considering A, B and D, so A we cannot travel, okay, so B we could travel and D we could travel, right? So here from B, what we have to do, we have to consider. So B we are having D and A as its path, so we cannot travel to A again, so I'm just leaving it off. So here we could travel to D, so I'm just marking it as D, right? So from D, what we are doing, we are just traveling it. So C and B are the opportunities, right? So I'm just marking C and I'm just marking B, right? So what has happened over here is that I cannot travel further in this particular node. Why? Because C is already being visited, so I'm just ignoring it. So here I'm just considering B, okay? So the next step, what I have to do, I just have to traverse from D. So from D I could travel in C and B, right? So I'm just traveling in C and the other path I'm just traveling in B. So C and B are already visited, so I cannot travel in this particular path, so I'm just ignoring it, right? So I'm just standing at B right now. So the path for me to visit are A and D, right? So I'm just considering A and I'm just considering D, right? So here D is already visited, I'm just leaving it off. So when whenever I'm just considering A, whether I have traveled all the nodes, I just have to look at it. So whether I'm just looking at it, so A, C, D, B and A, so I have traveled all the nodes. So this is one of the solution for this particular Hamiltonian circuit problem. Okay, so once after traversing all the nodes, what we have to do, we just have to write down our opportunities for our Hamiltonian circuit. So I'm just writing it down. So Hamiltonian circuit. So what are the paths in which you could travel? So you just start over here and then backtrack. So for example, I'm just starting with A. So I'm traveling to C. I'm traveling to D. I'm traveling to B and I'm traveling back to A. So this is one of the opportunity for me to travel, right? So this particular path I'm just considering it and I'm just traveling, marking it out. So similarly this path also I could consider. So I'm just marking A, so then I can mark B, so then I could mark D, so then I could mark C, and then I could mark A. So this is how I just have traveled, right? So this is how I am just marking it out. So these are the opportunities for me to construct a Hamiltonian circuit with the help of your backtracking approach, right? So your backtracking approach solves the Hamiltonian circuit in this particular approach.